Good morning. I just wanted to make this video about using organic products in order to get rid of some insects, especially this leaf-footed nymph that I had an infestation of just as yesterday, and what I did to get rid of them. These are my romas, and if I can look very quickly over here, I'll just focus in. You'll see a dead nymph right there. I think they're like, they're just babies from the larger insect. I don't know if the larger insect has a different name, but this one is called a leaf-footed nymph. And I know that I initially got it confused with the milkweed assassin. And I guess it was all over the internet. And they were in a very, very large bunch covering my tomatoes. And now I'm going to come over here because there is still one alive that I just found. And hopefully you can see him. I'll try to see if I can focus in. That's him right there. And I'm about to spray him with some neem oil, organic neem oil. He's running away. He probably hears what I'm saying. Some organic neem oil and Dr. Bronner's peppermint soap. I was doing this mixture, 1 gallon to 2 spoons of neem oil and 2 spoons of tablespoons of the peppermint soap. So here's the peppermint soap that I get from the grocery store, and this is the neem oil that I got from Amazon. And I was doing that as a kind of like a broad application to my tomatoes and plants and stuff like that. But for these guys, either I was missing them or going too light, so I decided to use the spray bottle. And this spray bottle contains 2 to 3 tablespoons of neem oil and about, 1 to 2 tablespoons of the peppermint soap. I just start with 1 and then I increased it and so forth and so on. But I find that you really got to get them on contact, and they die within 5 seconds. The trick is also that the neem oil quickly separates from the soap, not the soap, or the liquid. So it sticks on top. So literally, like, the moment you put it down, it starts to separate, so you have to constantly shake it, which is okay. I was also trying to shake this big bottle with the soap mixture in it, so it was kind of tough, but they are dying, and I'm really happy about it. So I'm going to shake this up. This is about 32 ounces of mixture. And I hope I haven't lost the guy. Here he is. And forgive me if... Get you. All right, this guy should die. Another really important note is that when I started to do this, I kind of left the neem oil and soap kind of sitting on the leaves. And I usually do the application at night, and so the leaves don't burn, but I was so upset that they were damaging my tomatoes that I did it during the day. And if you leave this on, it will burn your leaves. And I'll show you the trial and error. Oh, this looks like something here. This might be a big guy. I don't know if you can see him. Pick him up on the camera, but let's see. Oh, there he goes. This might be a bigger dude right here. So I'm going to grab my trusty neem oil. Excuse me. Hopefully I can find him again. Oh, I just lost him. And I lost him, just like that. Darn. All right, well, I'll look for him. Anyway, fast sucker. So, I don't know if you can see that some of my leaves have been burned. If I leave them on. So what I do is that after I kill them and they die immediately, I only use water. I empty out my mixture or I dump it somewhere, and I just put water and I spray and I hose the whole thing down. So the neem, the soap and the stuff is not on the leaves and the leaves don't burn. And then for extra precautionary, I water the plant. I give it, you know, enough water. So ideally it's good for night, but at night I couldn't see the darn nymphs. So I had to do it during the day in order to see it. Oh man, I really wanted to catch that other guy. Anyway, and of course I'm dealing with some other things like blight, because it's been raining like crazy. And I've been using baking soda and water for that. But I just learned that recently, and hopefully, you know, they're already hurting, so hopefully I can also keep up with that. But anyway, if you're battling with these nymphs, I keep forgetting the name, leaf-footed nymph, definitely the neem oil and soap on contact. Remember to rinse them off with water, you know, as soon as you can, and just water around it just for extra measure. And the numbers have, I only saw one, comparing to, I don't know, 50 that I saw. I'll try to take a close-up of what the damage is. This is a tomato that they were all on, and it's not ripening. What's happening is it's all spotted. It has red, kind of orangey spots on it. And so that's gotta go. They will suck the juice out of that. And I lost one tomato already. Anyway, hope you're able to get rid of these guys. You'll find them really easy, because they'll just completely cover your tomato and they're orange. This is another dead one. Let's see if I can focus on that one. But you can look them up also to get a better picture of it. All right, I hope I was helpful, and have a great day.